Signal received. Transmission secure. All right, Cypher. Looks like this is the real thing. Ready to invade the Eagle's Nest?
You'd better believe it.
The Eagle and his men are holed up in an old refinery beneath the river. Sending coordinates now. You'll lead the forward assault, but military reinforcements will surround the base and follow you in. Primary objective is to capture or eliminate the Eagle himself.
Acknowledged and understood.
Your secondary objective is the Eradicators. The terrorists have begun launching their biomechanical weapons over Imperial worlds. Once the devices are ready, the terrorists can fire on cities and military bases from orbit.
It never should have come to this.
We were too busy defending against Republic superweapons to look for threats from within. When you're in that base, don't let anyone escape. Don't let the Eagle murder again. Watcher 2 out.
Sir, we're cut off. Thurston and Gerald tried to get out, but the Imperials are all over the swamps.
They would be. Damnation. I promised Gerald she'd die with the detonator in one hand and a glass of brandy in the other. Seems she's made a liar of me.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't be. You were everything I could have hoped for. Now carve us a path out. I'll follow soon. All right, I see you. The least I could do was send the boy off with hope. But have you seen the strength of the revolution? Cells on Nar Shaddaa, Tholot and Molovar, Alderaan, Balmora. It's an inspiration, no matter how it ends.
Your inspiration is terrorism. Plain and simple.
Nothing is plain or simple about terrorism, about rebellion, or about covert intelligence. That's your field, I presume. You don't look military. Tell me something. How much of my story has the Empire uncovered? What have your methods found?
We found out all about your little orbital weapons. Your eradicators.
Look behind me. That is an eradicator. Technology developed on Dromund Kaas and Balmora. They can be grown anywhere. 6 dozen are already in place. They'll wait to receive orders, at first. But eventually, without commands, they'll run rampant. Fire blindly at cities from orbit.
Why would they do that?
Consider it a safeguard. Uncontrolled, the eradicators won't hit our targets, but chaos and death still send a message. Now we're done. May whoever survives see a glorious future for the Empire.
Storm Herald.
Damnation. Even surrounded, even seeing you, I didn't think it would happen like this. But as I said, it makes no difference. The eradicators will run rampant, the Empire will burn, and you have been betrayed.
Who's betrayed me?
My patron. The one who showed me how to unite the cells, proposed the eradicators, is one of your own people. A traitor in your empire has been helping us all along. Your civilization is so corrupt that it's destroying itself.
Shut up and die.
All clear. The building is secure.
Cypher 9, good to see you again, sir. I don't know if you remember, I'm Watcher 3. We met on Dromund Kaas. Keeper sent me with your reinforcements.
Glad you could make it.
My orders are to check the Eagle's computers, see if I can retrieve any data. I'll also check out that device there. I think it's an eradicator.
Move fast. The eradicators may still be a threat.
Yes, sir. Cypher, I've got some preliminary findings. It's not good news. I overheard what the Eagle said. Looks like he was telling the truth. If no one gives the Eradicators new orders, they'll go mad. Fire randomly.
Any idea how to disable them?
Here's the good part. I figured out their control mechanism. Transmit the proper codes, and you can set the device's targets, disable them, anything. The Eagle stored half the control codes on his computers. Someone else must have the second half.
You're good with computers. Fake the damn codes.
I'm really sorry, sir, but I don't think I can. I'll do my best. You should head to Drummond Cass. I don't think there's anything more you can do here, and Keeper wants you back at headquarters.
Cipher 9, come inside. This should be a triumphant moment. It's a tremendous achievement, bringing down the Eagle. The crisis has only escalated. The Eradicators could begin firing at any moment.
What's our current status?
Watcher 2, your report.
The Moths have placed local forces on alert, and a search for the Eradicators is underway. Unfortunately, trends suggest we can only find one device every 5 hours. It'll be weeks before we destroy them all.
Disappointing, but not a surprise. Damage projections?
Estimates are 10 to 50 million deaths on each planet targeted. 40% military, 60% civilian.
Even at the low end, that's unacceptable.
Agreed. It sends the message that the Empire is vulnerable.
In order to deactivate the Eradicators en masse, we need the control codes. Half the codes were on the Eagle's computers. We can only surmise that the other half are with the Eagle's patron.
Yes, the patron. The man whom the Eagle claims is inside the Empire.
Any idea who it could be?
I have my doubt that this patron is really a highly placed Imperial. It seems unlikely such a person could escape our scrutiny. Nonetheless, we can't ignore the possibility of a traitor. That's why we're meeting privately. Only the people in this room know the full situation.
Caution would seem prudent.
Indeed. Watcher 2?
The Eagle had been sending periodic transmissions to someone in the Artus system. Artus is uninhabited, devoid of resources and off the major hyperlanes. Our patron could certainly hide there.
I want you to lead a mission to Artus. You're to find the Eagle's patron and obtain his half of the control codes. Watcher 2 will rendezvous with you there. She knows more about the Eradicators than anyone.
I'll be glad to have her around. We'll get the job done.
Your ships will be outfitted with cloaking devices. They'll only last one jump, but they'll get you into Artus unnoticed. After that, infiltrate whatever base the patron is using. Recover the Eradicator control codes and stop the threat. Watcher 2, you're dismissed.
If you want to talk before the mission, I'll be at my station.
There is one more thing. Darth Sorid heard you were returning to Drummond Cass. She wants to speak to you.
Any idea what she wants?
No, she tells me very little. When you're through, head to the Artus system. This is our only chance, Cipher. Fail, and we all pay a grievous cost.
Cipher, I'm glad you stopped by. I've been going over the mission parameters, studying the Eradicator control code, scans of the Artus system. We're facing a mystery, and I hate mysteries.
You should get some rest before we leave.
I don't remember how. Times like this, I wonder if it took much more to push Watcher X over the edge. What about you? What's been going through your head since this countdown to Eradication Day started?
All I can think is that someone's betraying us.
Don't. Keeper knows the players involved, and Lodenth and I can run the psychological profiles. If someone's disloyal, we'll find out.
Aren't you suspicious of the people here?
This isn't the time or place, Cipher. I won't discuss the matter further. In any case, you should get ready. The Eradicators won't wait for either of us.
No time for chat, then.
Even less than usual. Once you take off for the Artus system, I'll be on your tail. We'll meet out there.
Physical trauma includes electrical burns, lacerations, and retinal damage. Transfer to a Colto tank for long-term recovery is strongly recommended.
You suggest a Dark Council member hide in a vat? For healing?
I am programmed to dispense medical advice based on all relevant factors.
Get out! Have yourself disassembled, made into a probe and sent to the most desolate place in the Empire! Look, Agent, they hurt me, and then they laughed. How could they?
Who did, my lord?
I thought I was ready. I called the council to assembly. I demanded the lords give me the respect I was due. Some were angry, mocked me. They tormented me and warned me not to overstep my bounds again.
The Dark Council did this.
They called me an arrogant child, unworthy of my position. It's all Jadis's fault. He was my master, but he never taught me what I needed to know. Now he's dead, and I'm not ready for his council seat.
If you're not fit for the responsibility, you should abdicate.
All my enemies would strike at me then, and all Jadis's too. I know what's happening in Imperial Intelligence. I know you're going on a mission, and that the Eagle wasn't the man you thought. Swear that you'll find whoever really killed my father. Swear that the man responsible will pay for forcing me into this wretched life.
I swear I will make him pay.
Yes. You will exact my revenge. And the world will be made right. I have gifts for you, Agent. Take them with my blessing and leave me to salt my wounds. And to gain strength from my hatred.
This place is stark. We smell no pheromones, feel no auras. We should be cautious.
Cypher, there's no one to welcome us. Seems our cloaking device has worked.
Don't get overconfident. This could be a trap.
I'm aware of that possibility. This starship is a modified Imperial Dreadnought, maximum crew complement of 5,000. It's also jamming long-range communications, so I can't check its registration or call for reinforcements.
Can we neutralize the jamming field?
Maybe. I'll see if I can locate the signal generator. Nonetheless, top priority is finding the eradicated command codes before the weapons initiate a random firing pattern. This data spike contains our half of the codes. Once you obtain the other half, you should be able to control the eradicators from any computer.
Any idea where the codes might be stored?
If we're lucky, they'll be on the bridge computers, and you can deactivate the eradicators from there. If they're not, I don't know. I do have one other thing for you, a comlink implant. So long as you're wearing it, I can monitor your situation and speak to you privately.
I assumed you were coming with me.
While you search the interior, I'll try to slice the security systems. We're counting on you. Put an end to this.
It's a grand social experiment. There's probably 100 of us from across the Empire. All saved from the fire. Who knows how or why. For the most part, we're left to ourselves. Squabbling and fighting. Left to fear our own shadows. But we know the Master's out there. And I'm convinced there's a plan at work. Somebody wants to change us. Someone wants to control us.
Thank you. begin.
It's been... I don't know how long it's been. I lose count of the days during the blackouts. The ones furthest along. They say our terror transforms us into the Master's image. Well, I'll tell the Master what's really happening. We're learning to fight back. Do you hear me, Master? We'll kill you for this. We'll kill you!
So happy when I got the invitation. Everything was going to change for me. Leave home for a year. Why has the Master picked me to survive when hundreds died? And now the rest of us, one by one. My mother was a slave, but I wasn't, because my father was an officer. I don't want to end up like her. Oh, please. Please, someone rescue us.
Something's wrong. Like rot within the hive. There is taint spreading through the Unity.
So, you've arrived at last.
Cypher, I know that voice.
I expected too little of you. You served me well on Hutter and on Dromund Kaas. I should have known you would serve me again.
Are you responsible for this?
Everything that has transpired has been at my command. My will is the destiny of lesser men. Once before, you were inoculated by the dark side. I will speak now as I spoke then. Accept the gift of your life, Agent, and we will discuss Terror, the Empire, and the Sith.
Give me one good reason not to open fire.
My tolerance has limits. Your destruction serves neither of us.
Don't, Cypher. You know what he's capable of.
I'm trying to analyze the situation, but it'll take time, and if he has the command codes...
It was my desire that the Eagle unite the Terror Cells. It was my desire that my flagship be destroyed. I required a weapon that the Dark Council would overlook. The terrorists became my unknowing servants, and carried out my plan.
You sanctioned the murder of Imperials. You faked your own assassination.
Only to achieve something greater. With my false death, I escaped the eyes of the Dark Council and of Imperial Intelligence. After the Dominator, I came here, bringing with me those passengers worthy of elevation. I maneuvered my pieces into place.
What's the point of it all?
Keep him talking. Damn it. We can't fight him on our own. His power is second to the Emperor's.
I accomplished two things during my absence. First was the diminution of the Dark Council. Upon my death, my former enemies began warring amongst themselves, vying to claim my resources. Darth Jorid's arrival escalated the chaos. My daughter is doomed, but she is an adequate distraction.
I can't call for reinforcements so long as that jamming field is active. But he'll annihilate anything less than an army.
You said your death accomplished two things. One was weakening the Council. What was the other?
Throwing the Sith into disorder was only the start. The rest of the Empire had to be prepared as well. That was the Eagle's purpose, to sow fright and hatred. All this while, my Eradicators were growing. Now they are ready, and my victory is close at hand.
You're as crazy as your daughter.
You fail to understand. The Eradicators will destroy the strongholds and apprentices of my enemies on the Council. So too will the Eradicators terrorize the Empire. Then I will return to the Council and lead the Empire into a new age, an epoch of terror.
It's an ambitious plan.
I see where this is going. He needs the Eradicators to make this work, but you have half the command codes.
Under my rule, all people will revel in fear and degradation. These prizes will no longer be hoarded by Sith. But without both halves of the Eradicator codes, my weapons cannot be targeted. They will merely cause chaos.
Mere chaos isn't enough for you, is it?
No. The Eagle's death, your acquisition of his codes, has forced me to adapt. Without orders, the Eradicators will fire blindly. This serves neither of us. Enter your codes into the ship so the Eradicators can target my enemies. You will be rewarded. You will be my herald.
Last time you promised me something, you faked your own death.
I misunderstood your role. Consider what I can offer now. Authority, wealth, a place in my vision. The respect intelligence has denied you.
What does that mean?
Blood purity is a notion whose time has passed. Consider an empire where there is no limit to what an alien might become.
I need some time. It's a lot to take in.
Very well. But understand this. If you refuse, you will die at my hand. The Eradicators will still reap untold destruction. Your sacrifice would mean nothing. I can be merciful. Take the time to consider your choice. Then we can begin the true work.
You haven't thought this through. Kill me and I take the codes with me.
A bold sentiment, but not a wise one. With your death, neither of us achieves our desire. And only I will be in a position to form a new plan.
That would be unacceptable.
Then you must reconsider my offer. I will leave you to your thoughts.
All right, stay focused and don't look at Jadis. How are you holding up? Can we put together a plan?
I'm all right, but I don't think we have much time.
We need to re-examine our priorities. We came here to stop the Eradicators, but we weren't prepared for reality. Our plan now has to focus on neutralizing Darth Jadis. Everything else is peripheral.
There's still an imminent attack to worry about.
I'm sorry, Cypher. The numbers aren't in our favor. You can deactivate the Eradicators right now. Just combine the codes in the bridge computers. But to keep Jadis from reactivating them, you'd have to blow up the ship's reactor. It's a suicide run,
and chances are, Jadis will escape.
Eradicators would be disabled. That was our mission.
It's not that simple. If Darth Jadis escapes, he'll come back. Not next year, maybe, but eventually. There's another way. A way to stop him from hurting anyone again. We can lure him into a trap by earning his confidence. Give him the codes to the Eradicators, and let him launch his attack.
Say what you have to say.
Prove your loyalty, and he'll turn his back on you. He's too arrogant to do otherwise. Once the Eradicators start their bombardment, you slip off the bridge and take the ship apart. You sabotage the jamming field, hyperdrive, and shields. Then I can call in reinforcements. The military, the Dark Council, forcing Jadis to surrender. The Eradicators are deactivated as soon as feasible.
How many people, how many worlds are sacrificed?
Let's be clear. If we give Jadis the command codes, then yes, he'll murder thousands before we stop him. But the human cost is acceptable. The only alternative is to let Jadis escape and do worse down the line.
The human cost isn't acceptable to me.
I can't tell you what to do, Cypher. If you disable the Eradicators here and now, I'll help you. We'll destroy this ship, save a lot of people, in the short term. But my advice is this. Use the codes to let Jadis launch his attack. Sacrifice lives and seize this chance. We can end his threat forever. Eradicators are offline. Repeat, the Eradicators are offline. Let's hope this works.
I expected more of you. Disabling the Eradicators will not stop me. You will die unwarned, and I will reactivate the devices and begin my assault.
Really, Jadis? Have more faith in me.
Whatever you think you are capable of or believe you have accomplished, all of it is dust. Only I am eternal.
He'll kill you, Cypher.
You can't fight Jadis, but you might slow him down. This ship can generate internal ray shielding.
Now, kneel before your doom.
If you can reroute the power, we can trap him in a force field, then get to the reactor core and destroy this ship.
Dawn Herald.
Uploading bridge schematics. You'll need to take out these components to reroute power to the force fields. I still need more power to get that force field up.
Thank you.
them distracted, and I can raise the force field.
Our Dawn Herald.
Almost there, Cypher. Just a little more. Slicing into the ratio controls now.
Agent?
Ship's power level's becoming unstable. You did it, Cypher. This whole place is about to explode.
What's the fastest way out of here?
Your ship's still safe. I calculate it's your best chance. As for Jadis, he's out of the force field and on his way to a shuttle. No way to catch him. But he won't recover from his setback anytime soon.
Too bad we can't make him pay.
You decided that stopping the Eradicators was more important. You knew what you were doing. I'm taking off, but I'll wait in system as long as I can. You need to get out before the reactor detonates. Good luck. I was afraid you wouldn't make it, Cypher. Good to see you alive. The self-destruct sequence is complete. Jadis' ship has been reduced to cinders in Artis V's gravity well, and the Eradicator command codes went with it.
Any way to know what he'll do next?
No. I didn't even get a course projection when his shuttle jumped to hyperspace. I'm sending a message to Keeper. These events will cause complications among the Sith, but I expect the Dark Council will sort matters quietly. They'll keep Jadis on the run, and we stopped a massacre.
I know you had doubts about the plan.
I ran the numbers. I dread the day Jadis returns and what he'll do. But the call was yours, and I'm glad no one had to die.
The Song of the Universe favors our actions. The Nest, our empire, is stronger for it.
I'm glad you are here to help.
So are we. We've often been uncertain about our place in intelligence, but not right now.
The Bug Boy has a point. You didn't do bad. I'd have gutted the Sith, though.
You really don't care about the people we saved, do you?
Come on. We all die eventually.
I'll see you at headquarters, Cypher. Enjoy the downtime while it lasts. There'll be debriefings, cleanup, and sooner than you think, Keeper will have your next assignment.
See you back at home, Watcher 2.
Mission accomplished. Watcher 2 out.